So today I'll be talking about my review on the Sony WF-C500. It has been a rather good experience thus far from the very first day that I use it. The app to set up the earbuds is through this Sony Connect app. As you can see in this screen recording of the setting up process, you need to download the app, you need to choose the headset that you are connected to, and you can actually register and log in an account to track your activities with the earbuds and sync your earbuds to your account. In the application itself, you could actually see the percentage of the earbuds, but not the case. The only way for you to know the percentage of the case is through the indicator on the case, which allows you to know whether your case has less than 30% of the battery or more than 30% of the battery, depending on the indicator. In terms of the case, I feel that there may be a little lack of a clicky feeling when opening and closing the case. For taking out the earbuds out of the case, I feel that it is fine as long as you have nails which are short enough. For the LED light on the charging case, I feel that apart from orange, they could have included like green or blue to show the differences between a low battery and having sufficient battery on the case, because it is only showing in the orange, and the differences is whether it is blinking orange or constant orange to differentiate the battery percentage on the case. The battery life on the earbuds and the case is 20 hours in total, which is advertised 10 plus 10. For my experience, I feel that it is kind of sufficient because I honestly do not use the earbuds to listen continuously for hours. So it is long enough for me, even though I know out there in the market there are earbuds which can go up to above 30 hours or 40 hours in total with the case. But I suppose having a longer battery life, it's always convenient for you to charge less frequently compared to something like this, which only supports up to 20 hours per charge. For the earbuds, there are physical buttons on it. On the left side, only single press has features on it, while double and triple press is just blank. And for the right side, single, double and triple presses allows you to do different things accordingly. For both earbuds, long hole actually allows you to do different things, and I feel that they should have actually included double and triple press on the left earbuds for some features, or maybe allow you to do some sort of customization through the app, but they actually do not allow that. For the earbuds, when you actually remove your earbuds in and out of your ear, there is actually no auto pause and play. So it could be a good thing, it could be a bad thing, because say if you just want to remove your earbuds to hear what's going on with the surrounding, the video will not actually pause and you could still enjoy your content while knowing what's going on in your surrounding. But it also could be a negative thing where you want it to be conveniently auto played when you put the earbuds into your ear, and the same for taking out of your ear to auto pause it. The earbuds itself has no active noise cancellation or hear through mode. To me, I would prefer to have both features in my earbuds when it comes to choosing them, because ANC is really useful to blocking out noises while on public transport, and hear through actually give me a pleasant feeling of listening to my own voice while I am on a call, so I would know how I sound like, whether I'm loud enough or soft enough. So for instance, when I go for a jog, the earbuds actually stays in my ear throughout my 2.4 run. In terms of its connectivity, there are two occasions where the connection actually dropped through my run, but the sound goes off for about 0.5 to 1 second for both instances. I'm not sure whether or not it is the earbuds or probably my watch, and yeah, I'm actually listening songs through my Samsung Galaxy Watch. As compared to while listening on my phone, there are actually no Bluetooth drop whatsoever at all, whether I'm actually watching my shows at home or while on public transport. So earlier in my previous video, I mentioned that the 360 reality audio is something that I am looking forward to. However, through setting up the application on my phone, I realized that the only way for you to enjoy that feature is through a third-party app with subscription, which I do not have, so that is kind of unfortunate for me. However, I did try out the sample that they actually gave to let me enjoy or to let me know the differences between a normal audio and a 360 reality audio, and they sound really good. Like, you could really tell the difference between a audio that's just going into your ear and the 360 audio, which you could really feel the audio coming in all sorts of directions, which is rather awesome. So if you have a subscription for apps like Tidal, it is really good for you to enjoy that 360 reality audio. Another feature in the earbuds or the app is DC, or the long form of it is Digital Sound Enhancement Engine. It's a technology that Sony has developed to actually enhance the sound quality of compressed audio files. So to me, I actually tried switching on and off in the application and I do not feel any differences in terms of the sound quality. The audio file that I'm listening to is downloaded off YouTube, so I thought it might be compressed, but perhaps the different type of song may differ in terms of its results. But the thing in the app that actually changed the differences in terms of the sound quality of the audio is really through this customization between the different preset that they allow, or you could actually custom one of your own. That is one plus point to actually tune the song to the way you like it if it is missing something or it is producing too much of something, such as the bass, treble, vocals, etc, etc. In terms of latency, I honestly think that there is minimal latency. I could not really see any off-sync audio between what I'm hearing and what I'm watching. But if you do see any latency, there is an option in the app to prioritize stable connection or prioritize sound quality.
So this is a sample sound recording of the microphone of the Sony WF-C500. I'm currently in a quiet environment and this is how it sounds like. And currently I'm playing a YouTube video on people talking in the background, so I'm not sure if the microphone does pick up on it, and I'm not too sure if this is a fair test as compared to actual background sound. And also one thing to point out while recording this is that I find out that there are no multi-point connection for the earbuds, which is a bummer because I feel that that feature is rather important for me because of how convenient it is for me to switch over from my laptop to my phone if I have a phone call, or say a tablet to a phone or phone to a laptop if I have a Teams calls, etc, etc.
So overall, the earbuds itself, the color is pretty nice. The fit is really good. There are no ANC, no hear through, no autoplay pause. There is an X for water resistance to your sweat and some splash of water. Sound is good, but not great. But there is an EQ for you to adjust it to your preference. And the physical buttons are great. However, I feel that if it allows customization, it would have been better. So yeah, this is my review on the Sony WF-C500. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. And if you have any opinion, do comment down. And feel free to subscribe for future tech products. Thanks for watching.